Closing arguments are underway in the trial against Thomas Kessinger, the man accused of killing his business partner 2 years ago and leaving her body under a tarp inside a van at a Linden apartment complex. WLKY's Lexi Sheen has been following the trial all week. She joins us live from the Judicial Center with the very latest in this case. Good afternoon, Lexi.
Good afternoon, Karen. The prosecution and defense have just finished up both their closing arguments in this case, and the trial is set to wrap up a little bit later on this afternoon. Now, the case dates back to April 2010 when Diane Tanselle goes missing and is found dead a week later. Her business partner, Thomas Kessinger, is eventually charged with her murder. While searching Kessinger's home, police discover a large marijuana grow operation, suspected blood, and also Tanselle's cell phone in his backyard. Yesterday, the medical examiner in the case took the stand, saying she was unable to determine Tanselle's cause of death, but that there was no evidence of any trauma. Diane Tanselle did have a heart condition, and her family indicated that she did not have her medication with her the night she disappeared. The prosecution offered a number of other suggestions on what killed her, but the defense says there's no proof it was murder.
It's absolutely stunning that they have indicted a man. There's a man on trial for murder. For causing the death of another person when their medical examiner does not know the cause of death.
Ladies and gentlemen, the defendant killed Diane Tanselle. He killed her and then wrapped her body up in a tarp and left her in a van to rot. He left her in a van, wrapped in a tarp, alone. No mourners, no headstone, no prayers.
Now, in addition to that murder charge, Kessinger is also charged with tampering with physical evidence, abuse of a corp, and also being a persistent felony offender. The defense does agree that he did dispose of her body, but they say it was only so that police did not discover his drug operation. Of course, we'll have the latest tonight at 5 and 6. Live at the Judicial Center, I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.